Incredible people. Thank you very much. This is an honor. You know, we just set this up. I said, there's no way I'm leaving South Carolina. And I was going to leave for tonight, come back. I said, I'm staying. So I'm staying here for 5 days. We've got to win on Saturday. We've got to win. We're going to take care of our military because our military is being whittled away, whittled away. We're going to make our military so big, so strong, so powerful, nobody's going to mess with us anymore. Nobody. 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 So, Nikki Haley, a very nice woman, she made a speech the other day. You saw that. And she was talking about anger, and she said there's a lot of anger. And I guess she was implying all of us, you know, really referring to us. And by the end of the day, she was actually saying that Donald Trump is a friend of mine, he's been a supporter of mine and everything else. You know, the tone at the beginning wasn't as nice. By the time that she was just barraged with people, she said, I think we better change our path here. And by the end of the day, and it was fine, it was great, but she said, yeah, there is anger. But I said, there is anger. And I was asked during, not this debate, but the previous debate, I was asked, by the way, didn't you love this last debate? I sort of liked it. They came at me from every angle possible. It's funny, these guys. So Putin said nice things about me. I don't know Putin, but he said nice things about me. He said, Trump is a genius, and Trump is going to win, and Trump is leading the party. All right, said nice things. Look, you know, I always like a compliment. We all like compliments. Not going to influence me. Believe me, I'm going to do what's right. But he said these things. So the other people said, we want you to disavow what Putin said. First of all, I say this. Guy calls you a genius, you're not going to disavow. Do we agree? But more importantly, if you look at it, wouldn't it be nice if we actually got along with Russia and other countries? Wouldn't that be nice? But, and I'm not saying it bragging. I'm saying it because that's the kind of thinking we need. Right now, we have $19 trillion in debt. We have $19 trillion. There's something going on. And when I did it in South Carolina. I told people in South Carolina, we have to have a temporary ban on Muslims coming into this country. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Take a look at Germany. Take a look at Germany. Everybody expected I was going to get Time Magazine of the Year because of, look at this. Look at this, people. But everybody expected it. And by the way, we have the same crowd downstairs. Can you believe after I'm finished, I have to do this again? Do you think this is fun? Do you think this is fun? And then they sent away 3,000 people. So we're going to have, like, close to 10,000 people. Amazing, right? Well, we did give you 3 days' notice, right? Can you imagine? It's an honor. So Boeing, I just tell you, in terms of what you have and what you've built, be careful, because they want to take those planes and they want to make them in China. And that's not good. That's not good. But believe me, if I win, it's never going to happen, because never going to happen. Never going to happen. China needs us more than we need China. Just please remember that. Obama never figured that out. Because why? Because they're sucking our money out. We have rebuilt China. We've rebuilt. You go to China, they have bridges like the George Washington Bridge all over the place. That's like a little bridge. Then we come home, we land at LaGuardia Airport with potholes all over the place. It's like we're a third world country. It's true. You see airports in different parts of the world, because I travel to these places, that are beyond belief. And we have LaGuardia, and we have Newark, and we have LAX and Kennedy, and they're all falling down and falling apart. It's so sad. Those days are over, okay? Those days are over. They're over. So I'm running against different people. It's so important that we win. It's so important that we start turning this country around. I'm running against politicians. I said, you know what? Dreamers, everything's fine. But I want the children of the people from this country to also be dreamers. I want our children to dream. I want our children to dream. So we're going to get our country back. We're going to have a strong country again. We're going to be respected again. We're not going to be a laughing stock like we have been. And we have been, believe me, all over the world. They don't respect us anymore. They don't respect us anymore. These politicians don't know. Thank you, darling. I love you, too. So what we're going to do is we are going to use great judgment. We're going to start off with a word that's very special, heart, because we all have heart. We're going to have great health care. And for the people, the few people, the little, the small, we can't let people die in the streets. Do we agree? We're going to have great health care, but we can't let some people that can't afford anything die in the streets. And everybody understands that. And Republicans understand that. But we're going to have great health care. We are going to have a country that you are going to, you love now, but you're going to love and respect so much more than you do now. I don't want your money. I only want your vote. So you have to get out. Saturday is such a big day. Keep it going. We're going to use common sense. We're going to use heart. We're going to use business skills. We're going to use our best people. We're going to use people that are so much more talented than there are anywhere in the world. We don't use them. We're going to use them, and we're going to make America great again, greater than ever before. Okay? Thank you. I love you. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.